Welcome back. We were discussing about real-time operating system earlier, which was, or which is rather, a time-restrictive and stringent requirement applications are there, then we use real-time operating systems. Now let us discuss about parallel processing or parallel processing systems. This is nothing but, we have already discussed the concept of multiprocessor systems where you have multiprocessor for execution of the task given. It goes in the similar lines but with a little bit variation as compared to multiprocessor systems. Okay, let's see how it is different or how it is. In parallel processing, the task or job, whatever is in hand, is divided into subtasks. See, these parallel processing are done where huge volume of processing as well, huge volume of data is involved. So, that huge volume of processing or data is divided into sub-manageable tasks. And then these subtasks are distributed to the processors available in the system. It is distributed amongst the processors available in the parallel processing system. The name itself indicates all these subtasks are executing, running parallelly. So, concurrent execution of multiple tasks is happening in parallel processing. What it requires? It requires more than one processor, obviously, because we want to process them parallelly. So that is multiprocessor system which I was talking about, to complete the task and all processor work simultaneously. I mean, there is nothing called one processor or one system need to halt so that only next system will start. So all are working simultaneously. It completes the task in very less time. Obviously, once the task is divided to multiple systems and those multiple systems are processed simultaneously, it takes very less time, right? So that is the major advantage. All the processors in parallel processing are tightly coupled and are present in one casing. What do you mean by one casing? We are talking about the hardware. These processors are put into one casing in a physical casing slots, right? So as tasks are initiated and stored in secondary storage devices or any other system, all the processors share common secondary storage device, that is hard disk or any other, it might be a server, anything. All these parallel processing systems share the same secondary storage device. In this multiprocessor system which has more than one processors which communicate in very close manner, that's what these are called as tightly coupled processor. What along with hard disk or secondary storage, they share memory, they share system clock, and with a shared memory they communicate. These are the thing with shared memory, because all processors sharing this memory and communication happens, whatever communication is done, that happens using the shared memory. So this is how parallel systems work. And if you look into advantage, we'll elaborate advantage a little bit later also. We'll just look into common advantages of this. Increased throughput. What do you mean by throughput? I have earlier told, this throughput is nothing but at one particular timestamp, how many processes, how many jobs, how many application it can process. One unit time. Unit might be anything. Economical. Instead of having multiple systems, we can have one system with multiple processors where we can share memory, where we can share processing clock, where we can share secondary storage also. it increases the reliability. How if something goes wrong with one processor, no problem, other processors will work. So that's what graceful degradation is there. If at all something goes wrong, it will not harm rest. So that is gracefully degrades, and which leads to soft failures. Let us say there are two types which were similar in your multiprocessor systems, symmetric and asymmetric. When I say symmetric, each processor runs identical copy of operating system independently. Many processors run at once without perform deterioration. There is no perform deterioration. All run parallelly without any interruption or any problem. The most modern operating systems support this concept, because every system is independent and parallelly they work, and there is no concept of, oh, I need to share the memory or something like that. Asymmetric, it is different, where you have concept of master and slave. Each processor is assigned a specific task. Master processor schedules everything. This master processor schedules and allocates work to the slave processors. So that is how this asymmetric processing done, and this is more commonly used in large systems, where in concept of client systems, where you need to work depending upon the work assigned by your master processors. In such systems, use asymmetric. Advantages, if you look into the advantages, are very much similar to multiprocessors which we have studied. If any one processor fails, then tasks are rescheduled to another processor so that execution continues. The task, say for example, there are 5 systems working, or rather I can say 5 CPUs working, say CPU 1 fails. The work of CPU 1 is distributed among 2, 3, 4, 5. So the process execution continues after rescheduling. So no problem with that. There is no concept of entire system goes to halt if some processor fails. If the need of the computing is increased, then number of processors also can be increased, if it is the conditional. Because say for example, if the workload in terms of computation as well as in terms of handling the volume of the data increases, you can increase the processors by increasing the speed of the system working. Increase in number of processor will increase obviously throughput. So it is win-win situation for both. Then is disadvantage. The major disadvantage with respect to this is extra cost incurred due to data transfer, asynchronization, communication, and when it comes to thread creation and destructions, all this incurs cost. Along with that, parallelization, we need to have proper synchronization, whether all simultaneously working systems are properly working or not. So that is one thing. When it comes to hardware stuffs, better cooling technologies need to be there, because if we have one processor itself we use in our single system, it used to have a fan and good ventilated rooms and all. Just think, what if we have multiple processors? So we need to have better cooling technology. And then obviously power consumption is more if we have all this. So power consumption is more. That is one more disadvantage. Parallel solutions are harder to implement. How to divide the task? What should be the parameter? What should be the criteria to divide the task into multiple tasks? That is a big challenge, because we cannot just divide it. What if the output of one particular module is input for other? So then we cannot work simultaneously. So there should be proper criteria and parameters using which the tasks are divided. So they are harder to debug if something goes wrong. These are all disadvantages with respect to parallel system. So multiprocessor and parallel system are almost one and the same, where in multiprocessor system we can have independent systems also, which are part of distributed systems. So this is different types of, when we study different types of operating system, we categorize multiprocessor with parallel with little bit changes. So this is how these processors work.